Vice President Lenny Robredo urges Filipinos to fight against efforts to whitewash the atrocities committed during martial law. She warns money and power would dictate history if the public will choose to remain silent about what really happened.
Kasama ninyo ako sa pagpalag, sa pagbantay, at sa paggiit. Pilipino ang susulat ng kwento ng Pilipino. Kailangan nating ulit-ulitin sa bawat pagkakataon ang katotohanan. Sa ilalim ng rehimeng Marcos, nagdusa ang Pilipino. Ninakawan, tinorture, at pinaslang. Ginamit ang ngalan para ibaon ang bansa sa utang at pagbabayaran ng utang na ito hanggang sa mga susunod pang henerasyon. Diktador si Marcos. At hindi niya napagbayaran ng husto ang krimen niya. Katunayan, patuloy ang pagpapakasasa ng kanyang angkan sa kayamanang ninakaw niya mula sa atin.
A Filipino historian believes one of the reasons why fake news surrounding the martial law years persist is because the Marcoses themselves have been able to stay in power. Xiao Chua, head of De La Salle University History Department, says this can serve as a reminder to the public amid the possibility the late dictator's son, former Senator Bongbong Marcos, will again seek a national position next year.
Because they cannot escape their father, although they wanted to really stand on their own achievements, they cannot escape the legacy of their father, and that's why they have to cleanse the memory of their father, which is sad, because they should have just acknowledged that there were bad things that happened during his administration. If they do not acknowledge and do not learn from the lessons of history, the things that their fathers have done or their mothers have done, then what do you expect? What are they going to perpetuate when they come to power?
The years under martial rule were the golden years for the Marcos family, but not the Filipino people. Human rights lawyer, attorney Shel Diokno, frowns at fresh attempts at historical revisionism. He says there were already videos surfacing during the early 2000s aimed at distorting the youth's perception on martial law. He adds there were not enough efforts from schools to educate young people. And now Diokno has this piece of advice for voters in the 2022 elections.
I just want to share something I learned from my father. He said, if we really want to build a just and humane Philippines, we need to have a national consciousness and a national conscience. At sana sa darating na taon na mabibigyan tayong lahat ng pagkakataon na pumili ng susunod na liderato, ay pumili naman tayo ng mga kandidatong may national consciousness at lalo na may national conscience.
Let's now dive deep into some of the numbers during those dark pages in Philippine history. According to the group Task Force Detainees of the Philippines, there were at least 9,000 victims of human rights violations from the years 1969 to 1986. The number of victims increased almost every year, reaching a peak in the 2 years preceding the EDSA People Power. 8 in 10 victims were males, mostly aged 16 to 40 years old, while female victims belonged to the younger age group, 16 to 30 years old. During martial rule alone, over 5,000 people were arrested or detained, with over 1,200 salvaged or apprehended and executed without trial.